The simplest way to select objects in 3ds Max is to use the selection tool on the main toolbar. Then click on an object in any viewport. When you mouse over an object, you'll see a yellow preview highlighting around it. And when you click to select it, a blue selection highlight surrounds the object. Also, when an object is selected, its wireframe turns white. In a shaded view, you can click anywhere on the surface of an object to select it. While in wireframe view, you need to click on a wire to select it. Selecting in this way works on one object at a time, meaning selecting a new object deselects a previous one. To make multiple selections, select the first object and then hold down the control key and add to the selection by clicking more objects in the scene. As a matter of fact, when you hold down control, you'll notice a little plus sign appears next to the cursor. To deselect objects from a set of selected objects, hold down the Alt key and a minus sign appears. Then just click on an already selected object to remove it from the selection. To deselect all objects, click an empty area of the viewport. When the objects you want to select are close together, it's easier to use a region select by clicking and dragging a window on what you want to select. By default, all objects contained inside or crossed over by the rectangle region become selected. We refer to this mode as crossing mode. You can turn region selection into window mode, where only objects that are fully contained inside the region borders are selected. You can toggle between window and crossing with the click of a button. Aside from a rectangle region, you also have a set of other shapes to choose from to define a region selection. A circular region, a fence region, which you start with a click and a drag, then click away to create the shape of your choice. There's a lasso region, which works with a click and drag to define the region, just like in Photoshop or other graphic applications. And finally, there's a paint selection that selects anything that the brush touches. Typically, this tool mostly used for selecting vertices rather than entire objects. Set regions to rectangle again and select crossing mode before we move on. Keep in mind that Control and Alt work when selecting objects using region selection. Control to add to the selection and Alt to remove from the selection. When a scene becomes very cluttered with objects, it's easier to select an object by its name using the Scene Explorer. By default, the Scene Explorer is located on the left in a docked panel. You can select one object or many objects at a time with the help of the Control key. The Scene Explorer panel consists of a menu bar, toolbars, and a table view of objects in the scene, with a row for each object and a column for each displayed object property. As you can see, this dialog underlines the importance of giving objects descriptive names. In the search area at the top of the Scene Explorer, type in seat, S-E-A-T. This brings up all the objects in the scene that have seat in their name. Select all the seat objects using Control and click. When you have a selection of objects that you know you need to repeat later, you can create a relationship between these objects in a variety of ways, using selection sets, groups, layers, and so on. For now, we'll look at selection sets. With the seat object selected, go to the main toolbar. Click inside the Create Selection Set, then type seat, S-E-A-T, and press Enter. This creates a selection set to make things easier. For example, deselect everything by clicking in an empty area of the viewport. Now go to the Selection Set drop-down menu and choose Seat. And this selects all the seats in the scene. Cancel the search term to see all the scene objects again. The same drop-down menu is also accessible at the bottom of the Scene Explorer. This is a very handy tool to catalog objects that go together. And selection sets are saved with the scene, so you don't have to recreate them every time you open the scene.